How often do you have an opportunity to become the owner of an iconic American flag? What do you think American is in America? treasure. There's nothing like it in this country. My name is Alan Harper. My wife Carol and I are the owners of the Durango and Silverton Narrow Gauge Railroad. It was built to service the mining industry in La Plata Mountains, San Juan Mountains. It arrived in Durango in 1881 and made it to Silverton in 1882. It carried the supplies in and ores out. As a kid, of course, like so many people, I had Lionel Railroads. My dad gave them to me. And I tease people that my railroads grew up, and I'm now in the 1-to-1 scale instead of O scale. I love history. I believe that the understanding of our past is critical to our prosperous future. Because history is really the roadmap to the future. I have this particular interest in railroads, so my niche in historic preservation has been railroads. And these railroads are dying all over the country. Steam railroads, historic freight railroads. And I'm convinced that I could make any historic property stand on its own without charity and taxes if it's done right. And I think the best way to preserve railroads is to make it interesting and exciting that people will pay a fair price for the experience. This year, this railroad will carry about 185,000 people. That's pretty much proof that our theory's right. And I've just really dedicated myself for the last 18 years to not only preserve the history of this railroad, but to carry that message to another railroad I own in North Carolina called the Great Smoky Mountain Railroad, but also to railroads throughout the United States. And I've traveled extensively giving talks about this very issue. Riding on the Durango and Silverton truly is a pleasure to do it over and over like a lot of our train, though, is meeting people. I get to meet people and share with them my passion for the idea of the railroad, but also see the joy in the faces of having the experience of railroad offering. And so you have this wonderful natural beauty that God gave us on the exterior of the car, but then you have this wonderful human lingering of people enjoying their lives with each other. What can be done? I think there is one other thing I think is very important about our railroad. You know, without the people that are the crews on the trains and the office people and the marketing people and the museum people, if I didn't have those dedicated people, this would be a static display, would be boring and would disappear. It would just disappear. So in addition to having this great trip that God gave us through the wilderness, in addition to having this marvelous historic equipment, our railroad is loaded with people dedicated to its preservation that love it as much as I do. You can walk through this railroad, and I don't care if you talk to a store clerk or engineer, you're going to find out those people love this railroad, and they want to share that love with everybody that comes. And that, to me, is just as important.